Greetings, everybody. I'm Ken Sumka, and this is 414 Live. Thanks for coming out and for listening on your radio. Welcome to our 414 Live session with Vitrolum Republic.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're listening to Vitrola and Republic on 414 Live on 88.9 Radio Milwaukee. Keep it going for Vitrola and Republic. Welcome. You know, band naming tip 101 is to be extremely Googleable, and one way to do that is to make up your own name, which is what you guys did.
Yes, we did.
Vitrolum isn't a word.
No.
That's awesome.
I don't think Googleable was a thing when we created it, but it's working out.
It worked out pretty nicely.
I don't think the word Googleable was a word long ago either.
So how long has it been then?
Nick and I are brothers.
Okay, so since birth?
you can clap for that, it's cool. Yeah. There's a woman in the audience probably responsible for that. So we kind of added members as we went. So that's the Republic part of the name. Each album we've added a member, and Alan Cote is our newest member. Looking forward to making a brand new album with him. The name kind of spawned from I make these wooden horn speakers called Bellophones, and we wanted to name ourselves like as a machine, like all together, sure, making sound like an instrument. Mm-hmm. How do we name that? And I think it was Nick who kind of spun off the word Victrola.
Okay, I was gonna say maybe did you go to the Latin roots of what vitriol means, or but I like that, yeah. Victrola.
Yeah,
that's cool.
There's a lot of energy in the playing, so maybe.
Yeah, it works. And like I said, when you go to Google your name, you get to like VITR and it just auto completes for you. And it's like, this is what you're looking for because the word doesn't exist, yeah, except for this band name. Yeah. So I think it's also cool that you kind of created your own little musical genre here, too.
Right, right.
Do you guys, what do you guys identify as?
Well, I think that's been a little bit of a goal from the beginning to use.
Congratulations on making that happen.
Thank you. Thank you. I think spawning from our classical roots was a big inspiration, growing up being trained classical, learning the instruments with a lot of intense repertoire, and then kind of breaking free from that. Spawning from that, by adding each member, everybody has their own history of how they learn their instruments, and it kind of keeps evolving. So.
And I'm not being coy when I ask this. Is there a classical training for the accordion?
Yeah.
Is there?
Piano, starts from piano. Actually, okay. Our grandfather played accordion.
Okay.
So he also played piano. And oddly enough, his brother played violin. So I don't know if
you're keeping it all in the family.
Something in that. We actually didn't find that out until later. So I don't know. Maybe that was destined since birth. I don't know.
There's no.
I mean, the people listening on the radio can't see, but this is like a 1930s, 40s drum kit that Ben here is playing. Is there a rule, or is it just by design, just happened that way?
It just happened that way. I think there's a common interest in visuals between, okay, us, and the music that we write has always wanted to inspire visuals and a soundtrack, if you will. And I think the instruments kind of go along with that. They're beautiful, but some of the older ones, you just can't make them that way anymore.
Sure. Would they get fired from the band if somebody brought in, say, like a synthesizer?
We've done it.
Have you really?
Yeah, we've done some things like that. The new album is it's pretty modern. It's pretty,
wow,
different from what we've done. So,
laptops?
A lot of laptops.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Excellent. So are there kindred spirit bands that you guys feel like you can kind of play with?
Well, we've pretty much grabbed the members of those bands already.
You've cannibalized them,
yeah.
Yes.
They're standing up here already.
So I would say you're amplified tonight, but I would say the instrumentation that you use, minus the bass and guitar, which you could play acoustic versions of, probably opens up a lot of opportunities for you guys to play in places that a lot of other bands couldn't, right?
Yeah, we love playing acoustic. We love, the instruments we've chosen, like, they're mainly, you know, able to produce their own sound without amplification. So we rehearse that way a lot. We write that way a lot. And, sometimes all the chords and the pedals, they just get in the way from what the real, you know, meat of what you're trying to get at.
Saying.
Thank you.
So there is some technology element.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I think that's the new wave for culture in general. I think there's always going to be an arc back to something, but because of the technology becoming so threadless and invisible, mm-hmm, I think there's always going to be a beautiful touch for tangible objects in the world. And as a musician, you get your gear, you get your instrument, and those are important. So that goes along with your last question too.
Sure.
Yeah.
So part of the reason you guys are here is next week your music will be featured in a ballet performance.
Yeah, it's very cool.
Tell me a little, or tell us all a little bit about that and how it came to pass.
Through friends in the community, somehow we got under the...
No, it's with Milwaukee Ballet.
Yes, yes. The Milwaukee Ballet. One of the choreographers came to our concerts a year or two ago. And the collaboration started fairly recently. But back then he was, you know, inspired by our style and what we're doing. He's like, oh, are these guys available for this? And Isaac found us and asked us to play. And we're super, you know, super excited to... allow the music to kind of, you know, take shape, take wings, and move. You know, we've always thought of the music having some kind of visual supporting it.
And so, was the music already there, or did you compose music specifically for this?
Well, the music that Isaac chose specifically was from our newest album.
Okay.
And for the Love Spun Ramblings and Ghosts in Our Shoes. And he found three tracks off of that that fit the story he was trying to weave with his different choreography.
Very cool. And have you guys seen the choreography yet? Have you seen it?
Little snippets on Instagram, but tomorrow we're going to go check out the rehearsal.
Excellent.
Yeah.
And so this will be next weekend, right? Is it?
Next week, February 8th through the 11th at the Pabst Theater. And you can get tickets at milwaukeeballet.org. And come out and support some really cool collaborations. There's five bands or musicians lending their music to five choreographers. It's going to be really cool.
And it seems like it's kind of a novel way to introduce people to ballet, maybe. I think people think ballet, they you know, some people think it's a little stodgy, and this, I think, is a cool entree into...
Yeah, the orchestras and the ballets are doing a wonderful job evolving with the culture. It's beautiful.
Excellent. Can we get one more song from Vitriolum Republic?
Yeah. We're going to play a song called Show and Tell.
trees can do.
Petroleum Republic, keep it going for them. They are part of the Milwaukee Ballet Performance next week, Milwaukee MXC, MXC, Milwaukee Mixed. And again, the dates on that, is there, I know there's one matinee, right?
February 8th through the 11th, okay. At the Pabst Theater.
And the matinee, is that Sunday, I think?
Should be, yes.
Yeah, cool. Thank you. And as we learned earlier, you're easily Googleable, but what is your website?
Our website is thepetroleumrepublic.com.
Excellent. Well, thanks for being here. Introduce the band real quick, if you don't mind.
My name is Jordan Waroxa. I play fiddle. Thank you. this is my brother, Nicholas. He plays accordion and keys. Over here, we have Alan Cote on all the good strings, electric guitar, lap steel. Chuck Lawton on bass. And Benjamin Schaefer on percussion.
And together they are Petroleum Republic. 4&4 Live is presented by the Milwaukee Bucks with support from Milwaukee Brewing Company, Hi-Hat Lounge in the Garage, and the Prairie School. We also want to thank our live engineer, Lodi. Thank you, Lodi, for doing a great job. And as always, we want to thank our members, without whom this is not possible. For 4&4 Live, I'm Ken Sumpke. I'm going to send it back to the studio on 88.9 Radio Milwaukee.